Welcome to Busy Bride 101, wedding planning tips for the bride on the go. And I'm your host, Lisa G. McMillan, wedding and event planner at Exquisite Events and Consulting. I've been planning weddings for years, and as you begin to plan your wedding, you may have a lot of questions. I want to be a helpful resource you can turn to. Each episode is around 5 minutes and packed with tips and advice you can use and guidance to steer you in the right direction. Without further ado, here we go. Today's podcast will cover working with ceremony musicians. Anytime you have the opportunity and financial resources to hire quality musicians, do it. Don't get me wrong. Recorded music works well, but there's an excitement and resonance that accompanies the sound of music wafting through the air played live right in front of you, which leads me to tip number one. When hiring musicians, make sure it shows on the contract if they are playing the prelude music. The prelude music typically begins 30 to 45 minutes before the ceremony begins while guests are ushered to their seats. This point is crucial because most brides only think you only need 1 hour for music, and that's not necessarily the case. Allow me to break it down. During the processional, which is the entrance of the grandparents, parents, officiant, and wedding party, you'll need one song played while they walk down the aisle. A second song can be chosen as the bridesmaids and groomsmen are making their way down, unless you decide to use the same song used earlier in the processional. Then, a third song for your bridal entrance. Let's not forget if you decide to have additional songs for the unity ceremony or a song before the pronouncement. But wait, there's more. Musicians will need to play the recessional song as the wedding party exits the ceremony. As guests are leaving their seats, you'll need postlude music, which is played until the last guest exits. So this can be 5 minutes to 20 minutes of music, and musicians are paid by the hour. Tip number two, communicate clearly with your musicians the exact location, time, and size of your event. This becomes extremely helpful if your venue has multiple spaces for ceremonies. Tip number three, wedding musicians customarily have a list of songs for you to listen to online, and they definitely should have a list of songs they can send you for consideration. This reminds me of a consultation I had with a violinist over the phone with a bride. During the call, the bride asked if he knew a particular set of songs. I can't remember the titles of any of them, but he said, "Wait a minute, let me play a few pieces for you right now." And within seconds, we had a mini concert performed over the phone. It was absolutely a treat for our ears, and needless to say, he was hired. Tip number four. If you have a special song request not listed in their suite of music, usually they'll download the sheet music, learn that song, and charge an additional fee. Tip number five. Also on the contract, it should indicate what instruments will be played. For example, if you want a duo that consists of a violin and cello, well, it should reflect that on the contract. Tip number six. Whenever musicians are playing an outdoor event, they need and should be set up in a shaded area or under a tent. Their contracts will also stipulate what weather conditions in which they will not play. Tip number seven. Musicians usually wear black clothing to events. However, some of them are open to wearing your choice of outfit. For instance, instead of men wearing suits, they may wear casual pants and a shirt without a tie. Just discuss wardrobe preferences during your consultation. Tip number eight. As the musicians are setting up for your ceremony, they'll want to know who is going to give them the cue to begin music. If you have a wedding planner or coordinator, then they'll check in with each other and discuss cues. For outdoor events, I have a retractable 5-foot-long white flag, otherwise known as my wedding wand, and I use it discreetly away from the guests, but in full view of the musicians when it's time to begin each piece. Tip number nine. Find a reputable company that's professional has a website to listen to their music, and one who provides you with a contract. Again, one who provides you with a contract. Tip number 10. Have fun selecting the music for your ceremony and work closely with the musician regarding your preferences. Thanks for listening to Busy Bride 101, Wedding Planning Tips for the Bride on the Go. To keep up with us and learn more tips, follow us on Instagram at BusyBride101 or visit our website at www.exquisiteevents.info. Subscribe to get notified of new episodes and to share with your friends. Always remember, your wedding is for the two of you.